Hey guys, I did want to talk about this particular card. I also have Kolaghan and Ataka in foil, but they're pre-release. What is the price of the Elder Dragons? They will keep their price. They are fantastic cards and EDHs. The original Elder Dragons, minus the reprint, I believe in the Legend version, the original version of them, they're still extremely expensive. I love them to death. They are EDH gold. There are some cards that just make me happy and I don't care if I overtrade for it. Dragon Legends, Elder Dragon Legends in foil, no pre-release stamp because I honestly don't like the stamp, is what makes me happy. And there's no better dragon right now than this one. Maybe a Talker, I guess, could an argument could be made, but wow, this one is by far the most beautiful dragon I've ever seen. Just in foil, like, it's hard to capture these cards in, like, video because of the shine is not exactly, like, the wingtips are pink, and it's just, like, the way they designed this particular card is insane. It's very beautiful. That being said, when you trade for Dragon Lords and when you trade for cards like this, the main factor I look at is how liquid is said card. And you can have cards that are, like, Siege Rhino is extremely liquid. I can never keep those in my binder. You can have cards that are extremely, extremely liquid. And then you can have cards like, I don't know, who would want this card? This card is actually worth $4. Or, Domi is very hard to get rid of too. So some cards are extremely difficult to get rid of, but some cards are extremely liquid. And when you can, and it depends on your locals, I guess. So my locals, they're very casual, laid back, very relaxed. They like to play EDHs a lot and tiny leaders. So something like a foil dragon, they will trade a Liliana. Obviously you gotta make it even, but they will trade high value modern cards for foil Elder Dragon. And it, most of the times, I don't mind picking up this type of card because I know at the end of the day, the value's not going to plummet all that much, and there will always be the ability to get rid of it when you sense that it's plummeting. So some cards, like Bonfire of the Damned, when it was going to plummet, you couldn't get rid of it. My friend had over 25 copies of it, and he was trying to, like, get rid of it as fast as he could, and he couldn't get rid of it. He couldn't get rid of most of those copies. And the problem, and same with Master of the Waves, or Master of the Unseen. That card is immensely difficult for me to get rid of, especially the foil copies of it. So when you look at a card, you have to look at who in your locals, what do your local people play? Do they play Modern? Do they play Tiny Leader? Do they play EDHs? What do they like? Do they like foil dragons? Do you like foil angels? And lastly, how liquid is the card? So if this card, I sense that there is trouble with the card, I want to get rid of it. Like Narset, I want to get rid of Narset. A foil Narset, I will always be able to trade out of a foil Narset. I will always be able to trade out of this card as well. A lot of times people talk about, oh, I make money. You don't make money until you actually sell the card. So yes, a card goes up from $5 to $10, but until you sell it, you're not making money. Or until you trade it, you're not making any profit. That's one of the least talked about things in Magic, finance at least, is how to get out of a card, or that you don't actually make money because you're just holding onto that card and the card rotates and you're pretty much screwed. This card, I have no... It might go down, it probably will go down a little bit. But wow, it's a beautiful card, and I don't mind if this type of card goes down because I can get rid of it anytime I want to. Not this particular card, but, you know, a similar card like it. Bye, guys.